Much. There are quite some misconceptions about growing, and today I would like to help you to overcome at least seven of these misconceptions. So the first misconception is that we can keep feeding the world's expanding population with the existing agricultural technology. And when we have a closer look at the world, we see that we are growing from 7 billion to 9 billion, and that we are moving to live more and more in cities. And to produce enough food for all these people, water is the most important asset. In future, water will be more important than fossil fuel or energy is today. And in order to produce enough food, we will create new land for growing food in suboptimal conditions. And in those conditions, plants are not very happy, and they will become ill, they will get pests and diseases. And we will take more and more pesticides, chemicals, to treat them. And another thing, even if our trucks would run on water in future, 35% of the trucks on the road are busy transporting food or food parts from A to B, and probably in the end back to A. So we have to change the way that we feed the world today. The second misconception: we must make plants adapt to nature. This is not true. In nature, and even in the best Dutch greenhouses, plants only use 9% of their potentiality. And in real nature, they maybe use 2 or 3%. So plants are so very smart that they are able to adapt any circumstances in order to survive. And they can do that with very little of their potentiality. But that opens a lot of possibilities for us. If we would know how to make plants really happy, they are able to bring much more to us. And we started back in 1989, 23 years ago, studying plants as they grow in the field, in greenhouses, and we have working for almost 10 years on producing mathematical models in order to understand them. And the more we understood about plants, the more we started to see that plants can do much better. The third misconception is, this is paradise for plants. It's not true. This is paradise for us. If plants were to choose, they would say, this is paradise. Plants don't like sunlight. They have used to live under sunlight, but the only light that they take up from the sunlight is red and blue and a little far red. So this is what plant paradise really looks like. It's a merger of plant physiological know-how and high technology. We give plants only red, blue, and far-red LED light, and we combine that with very sophisticated climate control. And by doing so, we are able to grow crops in these kind of buildings. We call this a plant production unit. It's a multi-layer production unit, and we can make it multi-layer because we don't want any sunlight. And in the unit itself, there is only this mixture of red and blue. And in front of the unit where the people are working, of course, there is daylight or white light, otherwise you couldn't see the real colors of the crops. If we would have to produce 200 grams of fresh vegetables and fruits for one person a day, it only takes 1 square meter in this sort of buildings. So in order to feed 100,000 citizens, it would only take a plant production unit of the size of 100 times 100 meters in 10 layers. And if we take a closer look at that production unit, this way of producing enables us to be totally secure and safe. Without changing anything about the genetics, but just by optimizing the environment where plants are living, we can make them more beautiful and even more nutritious. And we can secure a very great taste, much better than we were used to. and we are able to improve the yields by 2-3 times the best greenhouse, and even 30-40 times compared to the open field. And very important, we are able to save at least 90% on the water use. And the big gift to us was that we never had any pests or diseases. So it appears to be true that when plants are very happy, they never get ill. They are not susceptible to pest diseases, so we don't use any pesticides. So that also solves the fourth misconception. Growing food is done horizontally, and it takes a lot of water and pesticides. It's not true. We are able to grow any crop. It doesn't matter if it's tomatoes, lettuce, strawberries, cucumbers. We can do anything, even medicines, medical herbs, for instance. And this is how it looks like. This is, of course, the image. And this is a plant production unit that we have built over 2 years ago. And it is up and running now 24/7 for more than 100 weeks. And it works perfectly. And we are able to control these units long distance by uploading growing recipes automatically. And those growing recipes take care of every minute set points to grow perfect lettuce, perfect tomatoes, and even guaranteeing that the nitrate content of that lettuce is very low. And as you see, they are really green when they come out. So the fifth misconception is that food must grow where nature is kind to it, and then we transport it. And that's why we grow 10,000 hectares of tomatoes in the south of Spain, and then we transport these tomatoes to Moscow, for instance, and we have to harvest them 5 days prior to the consumption moment. Otherwise, they wouldn't be able to be transported. But that is very bad for taste and nutrition. So we want to grow them just where we live, where the consumers are. We want to change food miles into food steps. We want to go back to the old concept where we consume food that is just harvested. And that makes a lot of difference. And in this system, we are able to harvest exactly at the right moment in the right quantity, meaning we have no waste. And we can do this no matter what climate, no matter what season, day or night, and we can do this any place. We could do this in desert, at the polar circle, or inside the city. And then there is the sixth misconception. Food must be grown large scale. That's not true either. We could do it in the center of cities or even at the fresh department of your supermarket, or even growing lettuce or herbs inside your restaurant, or even smaller. You grow your own herbs in your kitchen, or you pick your tomatoes from your kitchen drawer. Then the last and seventh misconception. It will take years before this is going to happen. That's not true. We are totally ready to do this actually today, and within the coming 1-2 years, we will start rolling out this concept, especially in Asia, China, India, Africa, etc. So indoor farming is the next generation of growing, and we are totally there to do it today. Thank you very much.